when I first came to Isha Yoga Center in 2019 as a general volunteer, I was completely clueless about the ashram rules. Still, I think I did a pretty good job in packing my bag. But I often see people coming with huge luggage, which is like easily avoidable. So I thought about making this video. Whether you're coming for a short visit, for long-term volunteering, or for advanced program, I hope this video will be helpful. So please watch till the end. Hi, this is Shadow and welcome to my YouTube channel. So before getting into the backpacking tips, let me share with you the basic dress code of the ashram. Well, each ashram has its own dress code, but I'm just sharing what we follow here at Isha Yoga Center. So the dress code is pretty simple here for both the guys and the girls. You're not allowed to wear sleeveless or anything above the knee, and also avoid tight clothes. Like, don't come here wearing tight yoga pants thinking it's a yoga center. We wear loose clothes while doing yoga. And if you're wearing sari, please don't show off your midriff or wear something backless. That's it. So if you're coming here for a short visit for like 1 week or so, I would say a small backpack like this size is more than enough. All you have to do is pack smartly. Don't fold your clothes. Instead, try rolling like this and you'll save a lot of space. Next is, I would say you don't even need an iron. I left polyester long back even before turning spiritual. So most of my clothes are like cotton or natural fabric. And the best thing about cotton is it actually do not need ironing. I always carry a hanger like this and I simply sprinkle water, and actually cotton holds the shape how it dries. And you can easily see it was so wrinkly at first and now it's completely wearable. But still, if you're coming as a volunteer, there are iron in the dorm, but I hardly use them because this is my secret technique. From my personal experience, I would say the best clothing option is carry some basic t-shirts and some loose pants with pockets. That's it. That's the best option because you'll have to walk a lot and sit on the floor a lot. Also, there's no proper winter season here, so I don't think you'll be needing heavy woolen clothes. But sometimes after unpredictable rains, early in the morning or late at night, things can get pretty cold. So I would suggest carry something full sleeve or something maybe like hooded to save your ears. I would say if you're coming for a short-term visit, forget about looking good. If you have your main life outside ashram, it's just my personal opinion, there's no such rules. But maybe if you're here for a short term, try not to wear something loud or not, you know, disturb the natural essence of the place by using any strong perfume. You just soak up the energy of the place. This is such a beautiful consecrated place. You won't understand what I'm trying to mean by consecrated place unless you stay here. Okay, so that was for short-term visitors. Now let's talk about long-terms. Like me, who's staying here for over 1 year because I work in Isha Foundation, or Sadhana Pada people who stay here for 7 months, or people who are here as full-time volunteer. So people who are staying here, ashram becomes a part of our life, and with our sadhana and this huge lifestyle change, things start becoming normal. Like, I don't think I have to force myself to, you know, stay focused and not getting distracted by the outside world. Because of my profession, I get to use social media a lot, but I don't have social media addiction, or even if I see something disturbing, it doesn't affect me anymore. And that is the power of sadhana. And because of my YouTube, I have collected some minimum makeup items that I'm wearing like right now, but on an everyday basis, I don't wear makeup at all. So here in the ashram, we do not have any parlor or salon to take care of ourselves. We live the simplest life possible, but still we're all happy here. Back at home, I used to wear makeup every day, style my hair every day. And for my dry skin problem, I used to drink 3 to 4 liters of water and still my skin was dry. Here, I drink hardly like 2 liters of water a day and still my skin is dry. But the only thing I figured out that worked for me is this sunscreen, and for moisturizing, hyaluronic acid serum. That's it. I'm 30 years today and I think I'm doing pretty good. So because all year I wear decent clothes, when I go outside, I like to wear short clothes. But my strategy is I don't waste all my money buying everything decent. So I wear short dresses, but I wear it with legging like this. Even if you're wearing a dress that is below the knee, I would suggest wear a legging because you will have to sit on the floor a lot. And like I said, we do not wear sleeveless dresses here, so you hardly have to take care of your body hair and all that. But when I go outside, I like to stay clean. So for that, this is like my lifesaver, my epilator. I've been using it for over 5 years. It has a epilator head and also a shaving head. And anytime I'm going outside, I'm good to go. Life is pretty simple. You just need to respect the rule of the place and take care of the basic hygiene. That's it. And do sadhana. That's the secret of a happy life. And if you need something extra like shampoo or toothpaste or sanitary napkin, we have a store here, or you can also order online. And for shoes, walking barefoot is the best option. Still, most of the time I walk barefoot. I still remember I had such good collection of heels and all kind of shoes when I was in Kolkata and Bangalore. All of it I have donated to my friends. But right now, only one sneaker and one croc. That's it. That's enough. You don't need anything else. Okay, so that was like a short-term visit or long-term stay. Now, the third category is if you're coming here for an advanced program like Shunya or BSP. Do not forget to bring extra clothes, because the advanced program schedules are so tight, you won't get any time to wash your clothes. So you better have fresh pair of clothes to wear each day. And don't forget to pack your bag this way. I think I've covered everything. Sorry, I didn't make any note for this video. If I have missed something, please write down in the comment and give this video a thumbs up or thumbs down, whatever you like. And please do subscribe if you haven't yet. You can also follow me on my Instagram. Link is in the description. That's it. Bye.